Hi, today my name's Matt and today I'm at Strengthforce Gym to talk to my PT research partner. Today I'm going to be taking you through a typical session that you do with one of his clients, following one of his clients round and just asking some questions based on the personal trainer.
Yeah, incredibly hard, because even as you progress and you get fitter, he makes the sessions harder, so you're always being tested. So there's never an easy session, but there's no point in going to a gym if you're going to have an easy session. And the way he keeps me motivated, keeps pushing me, and he seems to know my limits. Like whenever he's pushing me to do something, it always seems to be hitting my limit and making me really work hard, but at the same time, doesn't make me do too much. It's been incredible. I've lost, about 31 pounds now. I'm feeling stronger, getting muscles bigger. So, yeah, I'm not there yet, but a long way to go. To be honest, my old physique, from when I used to play football at high level, and I was always in good shape, I was really quick. Just how I've let myself go, that's my inspiration to get back how I was and how good I used to be.
Yeah. Way, way, way up. Turn it all up. Yeah. Look, I got enemies, got a lot of enemies. Got a lot of people trying to drain me of my energy. They trying to take away from a nigga. Fucking with the kid and pray for your nigga. I got girls in real life trying to fuck up my day. Fuck going online, that ain't part of my day. I got real shit popping with my family too. I got niggas that can never leave Canada too. I got two mortgages, 30 million in total. I got niggas that'll still try fucking me over. I got rap niggas that I gotta act like I like. But my acting days are over, fuck them niggas for life. Yeah, I got enemies, got a lot of enemies. Got a lot of people trying to drain me of this energy. Trying to take away from a nigga. Fucking with the kid and pray for your nigga. I got people talking down, man, like I give a fuck. I bought this one a purse, I bought this one a truck. I bought this one a house, I bought this one a mall. I keep buying shit, just make sure you keep track of it all. I got bitches asking me about the code for the Wi-Fi, so they can talk about the timeline and show me pictures of their friends, just to tell me they ain't really friends. Ex-girl, she the female version of me. I got strippers in my life, but they virgins to me. I hear everybody talking about what they gon' be. I got high hopes for you niggas, we gon' see. I got money in the court, so all my niggas are free. About to call your ass a Uber, I got somewhere to be. I hear fairy tales about how they gon' run up on me. Well, run up when you see me, then we gon' see. I got enemies, got a lot of enemies. Got a lot of people trying to drain me of this energy. Trying to take away from a nigga. Fucking with the kid and pray for your nigga. Yeah. Yeah. Nah, fuck all of you niggas, I ain't finished. Y'all don't wanna hear me say it's a go. Y'all don't wanna see win-win 50 or woe. I got real ones living past Kennedy Row. I got real ones with me everywhere that I go. I'm trying to tell you, I got enemies, got a lot of enemies. Every time I see them, something wrong with their memory. Trying to take the wave from a nigga. So tired of saving all these niggas, Mike.
How did you get where you are today?
So I became a PT about 5 years ago now. So before I was a PT, I played a high level of football. And I think having that sporting background and playing at a high level and working with PTs whilst I was at the football club kind of inspired me to do the same and help people kind of work towards their goals and help them become fitter and obviously lose weight, and that's what I do now. So I really enjoy my job. I think the coursework, there was a lot of actual coursework to do to the course, and I had to travel up to London every week to do the course, which I didn't enjoy doing. But once I completed the course, then I have no regrets. I love kind of what I do now. Like I said, with the footballing background, and I just love helping people. It's quite a satisfying job knowing that you've helped change someone's life or you've helped them achieve what they've always wanted to achieve. So just guiding people in the right direction. So I write diet plans, training programs. I plan all my training sessions. So when I'm with my clients, I try not to do every single session the same. I always try and vary up and mix up my sessions so it keeps them motivated and stops them being bored. Tyna, obviously I'm pushing my clients every day and I wanted to give myself something to focus on and just to kind of push me training wise and with my nutrition to kind of keep me on track. So I kind of like doing the competitions because it just gives me a focus and it gives me a goal date to try and obviously achieve what I need to achieve by that date. So that's why I do the competitions. This prep I just done, I prepped for 20 weeks.
What's a typical session that you go with someone like me?
So the typical session, what I'll try and do a weight base exercise and a cardiovascular exercise, getting their heart rate nice and high, as well as increasing their strength. And I'll also incorporate a bit of core work to improve their midsection. So in terms of the cardio, I'll use the prowler. So do a prowler sprint, which would be coming down, pushing as fast as you can, getting the heart rate nice and high, and then just a typical strength training, which would be a military press, so shoulders, increasing your strength in the shoulders. And then I'll do core, so I'll be holding the plank. Keeping your core nice and tight, sucking your belly button in. And there will be the three fundamentals exercise that I'll put into a PT session. On the stage. So when you do Men's Physique, which I do, you go on stage, and you do your four quarter turns, so you do your front pose, your side, your back and your upper side. And you basically you've got to try and keep what they're looking for is they're going to have a nice wide shoulders and that small waist, and they're looking for that V shape.
Before these competitions.
So I do it differently, I go high carb and low protein. But to be fair, as long as you're on a calorie deficit diet and you're training 2 to 3 times a day, you'll be absolutely fine. Food, definitely. Motivates me. Motivates me. Good question, Matthew. What motivates me? God.
a lot of things motivate me. I get inspired very easily, so if I watch a sporting athlete that I like and I look up to, then it kind of makes me work harder seeing them succeed. So that kind of pushes me and makes me work a little bit harder as well. Probably the long days, because you've got people who want sessions before they go to work and you want people who want sessions after they finish work, so you start really early and then you finish really late at night. I've got my level 2, my level 3, I've got my sporting coaching badges, I've got my nutritional course, my nutrition certificate, and I did it through a company called Premier Training, and you have to do their courses online.
Do you have to pay for them?
Yeah, you have to pay for them, yeah.
How much is like the highest certificate that you can get?
So level 3, and that costs around £4,000.
Quite expensive then.
Very expensive, yeah.